penalty papers are mandatory at all checkpoints.
Put the kiddies to bed already.
Is this seat taken?
I'm not looking for company.
You're in Paris, my friend. In this city, no one drinks alone. So, what are we celebrating?
We aren't. But if you're keen to get your teeth kicked in, I'll be happy to oblige.
I'd have thought you were too busy kicking yourself. With good reason, I'm sure.
What's it to you?
You think you're the only man in Paris hoping to drown a guilty conscience? This city is filled with men like us. We all have good reasons. I've been watching you these past weeks. I have seen that you have no love for the Nazis. The question is, how many more people will die at the hands of these jackbooted killers while you sit there cowering like a whipped dog? You're mad enough to break that bottle over my head, but you won't lift a finger to help these people, eh?
This isn't my country.
Oh, did you abandon your conscience at the border? Does the need for justice end at some line drawn on a map?
Aye, if it's a map of Ireland, you Frenchmen have unrealistic expectations.
Open your eyes! The war is all around us! You can't escape it! You can hide here and leave the fighting to braver men. Or you can walk out that door and do what must be done. The choice is yours!
Keep it down. That sort of talk will get us both a bullet in the back of the head.
I intend to do more than talk. There is a courtyard around the corner. Meet me there when you are ready to stop hiding. I see you're a man who'd rather die on his feet than live on his knees.
I'd rather the Krauts did the dying.
Excellent. There is a German fuel depot down the street. 5,000 barrels of precious petrol, guarded by a handful of half-drunk supply clerks.
Sounds like one hell of a fire hazard.
My thoughts exactly.
We'll need something to get the fireworks started.
I know a place where we can get what we need. But first, I must know. Are you prepared to kill if necessary?
Oui, I see it. These Nazi bastards bought their own tickets to hell. I'm just laying out the welcome mat.
That's my car there.
I'll drive.
Hello? let's get moving.
Where are we headed?
I spotted a German supply cache nearby. I am sure they won't mind if we borrow a few things. Have you ever handled explosives before?
I handled a bombshell once. Turned out she was married.
This is serious.
All right, keep your knickers on. I know what I'm doing.
I had a feeling you would. Merde, look at these fucking Nazis everywhere, infesting my beautiful city like cockroaches.
They certainly made themselves at home.
It's time we showed them a different kind of hospitality. The supply cache is down that alley. Let's go. Look at those spineless jackals. I can't stand it anymore.
Whoa, steady, mate. Let's just get what we came for.
Espèces d'enfoirés du merde!
Christ, here we go.
What the fuck was all that about?
Not now. Let's go. The crates are up there, but we need to be careful. The supply cache is a restricted area.
Oh, why? Was that you being careful back in the alley?
I lost my temper. It won't happen again.
See that it doesn't. I didn't leave a nice warm bar just to get my head blown off.
If we are spotted near the crates, the Germans will attempt to sound the alarm.
Then we'll have to get rid of that lookout first.
Yes. You should be able to find hand and footholds on the surface of that building. Climb up there and throw that Nazi piece of shit from the roof while I move in on the ground. Can you do that?
It's a piece of piss.
I do not know this phrase.
It means yes.
Irishmen, we could not allow them to sound the alarm. Now let's see what kind of party favors these crowds brought for us.
Break open those crates.
Those explosives will do nicely. Just remember to save at least one charge for the fuel depot. Let's get back to the car.
Feeling, Irishman?
I'm anxious to get the real show started.
Ah,
most men would have lost their nerve by now. Tell me, my friend,
What were you doing in Ireland before you came to my country?
I was a mechanic. Not that it's any of your business.
A mechanic, eh?
Well, the resistance could use a good mechanic.
I didn't know there was a resistance in Paris.
That's about to change. After tonight, the Nazis will have a new enemy to fear. The depot is just up ahead.
We'll need to create a diversion to get past that gate.
The Nazis are trained to investigate the sound of gunshots or an explosion. Use that to your advantage. 10 pounds of high explosive on that truck should get their attention.
Aye. That'll do.
Start by climbing that building. Once you're on the roof, keep your head down and wait until the truck explodes. Then, use that telephone wire to cross the street into the fuel depot. While the soldiers are distracted, move in quickly and place a charge on the primary storage tank.
I'll meet you by the gate when it's done.
Watch your ass, Irishman.
Look out below!
That's my cue. Time to leg it.
Change the course of history, my friend.
Well, all we did is blow up a petrol station.
Though I must admit it,
that fireball did make a pretty picture.
You are wrong, Irishman. Something has changed. It is in the air. Can you not feel it?
Well, now that you mention it.
Get some rest, my friend. We will have much to do in the days ahead.
Oh, aye. If by that you mean a sweet brunette and a glass of whiskey.
Enjoy your reward, Irishman. You earned it. I owe you a drink.
I'm somebody nobody loves. Oh me, oh my, my, my. I'm somebody nobody loves. I wonder why, why, why. Although I know it sounds alarming, I've been all vanity.
Ah, bollocks! What's got into you, mate?
What the hell are you doing?
What's it bloody look like?
Aurora is my girl now, Sean. I will not have another man picking up her skirt.
Oh, for fuck's sake, Jules.
You're a driver now. You want respect on the circuit? You gotta stop thinking like a mechanic.
All right, I'm put on airs like some posh wanker with a silver spoon up me arse. No thanks, brother.
Veronique!
Morning, beautiful.
I'm coming along for the race. Vittore asked me to take pictures.
Couldn't he wait till I'd made myself a little more decent?
I don't believe in miracles.
Oh, my sister got all the charm.
And the brains.
That's enough screwing around. We've got a race to win. You boys have work to do. Both of you.
Say the word, boss.
Let's get our girl on the trailer. I want to be across the border by sundown. Ready to move out?
The truck is loaded and ready to roll.
And the Aurora?
Trussed up tighter than a nun's arse.
Good. Veronique and I will ride ahead. You boys take the truck and head east to the German border. From there, it's a straight shot to Saarbrücken. I've marked the location on your map.
Come on, Sean, get in.
Yeah, yeah.
That's it, my friend. After tomorrow, you'll be a famous driver, and I will be right there beside you, reaping the rewards of your success.
Which rewards did you have in mind?
The women! These German girls are crazy for racers. We'll have a dozen blonde beauties feeding us grapes, huh? Assuming you don't fuck it up, of course.
Well, I appreciate the vote of confidence, Jules. But there's more riding on this race than you getting your horn knocked off. Vittori took a big gamble making me his wheelman.
You're not gonna let him down, Sean.
I hope not.
Vittori's got bigger problems to worry about these days.
Like what?
Like the fact that a war could break out any minute, huh? Don't you read the papers?
Just the sports section.
These Nazi bastards are itching for a fight. If they get their wish, we're all gonna be out of a job. There's the border up ahead. Drive slow and try not to look suspicious.
Right. I should have worn me lederhosen.
I'm serious. These assholes are looking for any excuse to start shooting.
Not much farther now. I can smell the petrol fumes from here.
You just keep your eyes on the track and the pedal to the floor, my friend. You let me worry about the rest.
Are you volunteering to be my manager?
What's so funny? I didn't have to be a mechanic, you know. I could have done anything.
Shite. This could be trouble.
Watch it! You'll damage the Aurora!
What were we talking about?
I could have done anything. The teacher used to say to me, Jules, all of these kids are stupid, especially your cousin Javier. But not you, Jules. You are too clever for your own good.
I thought Veronique got the brains in the family.
She likes to think so.
What's her beef with me anyway? I can't put a foot right when she's around.
Hey, it's not just you. Veronique is tough on men in general.
Why's that?
One of these days I'll take you to my family's cabaret.
I'm glad you finally decided to join us.
We took the scenic routes.
You run into any trouble?
Just the usual groupies, looking for autographs.
A toast to Team Morini and Our Lady Aurora.
To Signor Morini, for taking a big chance on a dodgy bloke like me. Another round for me mates.
Easy, Sean. You'll need a clear head tomorrow. Dirker flew in this morning from Berlin.
Kurt Dirker? I thought he was retired.
Speak of the devil.
Guten Abend, Herr Morini. Always a pleasure to welcome one of our Italian friends to the fatherland. I was just speaking of my admiration for General Mussolini. A kindred spirit to our own Führer. Your country is fortunate to have such a leader, yeah?
Racing is my passion. I find little time for politics.
Sometimes racing is politics.
No. There is a difference.
You must forgive my ignorance, Herr Morini. We Germans are a simple people. Perhaps you would enlighten us further?
One's a hobby for rich assholes who can't get laid without a flashy car and a silly uniform. The other is racing.
This must be that British mechanic who thinks he's a driver.
I'm fucking Irish.
It's getting late. Why don't we call it a night?
The night is young, Fräulein. Stay. Dine with me.
I've no taste for German cuisine.
Not yet, perhaps. But soon, the women of your country will learn to savor the taste of a purebred German bratwurst.
Bastard!
Boss, get my crazy sister out of here before she gets herself killed!
I am not going anywhere!
Enough! I'm taking her upstairs!
Four of them!
Was das los mit dir?
Ich greife seine schwache Seite an!
Pardon, you nasty freak!
Easy, mate! Save some for me! And stay the fuck down!
I don't think he can hear you.
Let's see if he can drive this broken fence.
Der Ehre flieht!
The barman's talking to the police. I'll take care of Veronique. You boys, get out of here!
Jules, time to get scarce.
Right behind you!
Bollocks. Watch it, you bloody... Fuck me. Skyler?
Are you chatting me up? Hello, Sean. Hi, Jules.
Meld. We'll catch up later. Right now, we need to borrow your car.
So much for awkward small talk.
Drive the fucking car! Hold on to your arses. Just like old times, eh, Skyler?
Never a dull moment. How long have you been in town?
Just got in, actually.
I see you wasted no time running afoul of the local police.
Those fellas behind us, they're just having a laugh.
Is this disorder routine meant to be a turn-on?
I don't know. Is it working?
Will you watch the fucking road, please?
The radio ahead has set up roadblocks. Double back and you should be able to slip through the net.
It keeps you down your posh English school.
Benefits of a higher education.
Are all English girls as crazy as you are?
Give us a bit of privacy, would you, Jules?
Oh, I'd love to, as soon as you check these crowds.
that was fun. Anyone fancy a nightcap?
Brilliant. I'm parched.
Fuck this. I'm not going to be the third wheel. Take me back to the hotel. Keep the noise down, Ed. I need some fucking rest.
Come on up. I'll sneak you in the back door.
Wouldn't have it any other way. Nothing like a brisk evening drive to quicken the blood. Except perhaps a single malt McGarren, aged 30 years.
Must be Christmas. Lucky for Jews and me, you came sliding down the chimney when you did.
Christmas, is it? Oh, I'm afraid I've been a bad girl.
Aye, I'm certain of it.
Whatever happened after that weekend in Monaco? You never rang me up.
You never gave me your number?
Oh, that's hardly an excuse. You're not still pining for Jules's little sister, are you? She's a bit of a bore, don't you think?
I don't think I'm her type. So, you in town for the race?
What can I say? I have a weakness for men in fast cars. I've been all over Europe following the circuit. Mum and Dad are mortified, of course.
Beats working for 11.
I wouldn't know.
What's this for? Shaving your legs?
A girl should always carry protection. One day you'll have to tell me how you came by these scars.
We've done enough talking for one night.